Second is milligram per liter. As I told you earlier, that milligram per liter is the second unit is represented like this. So how we explain it, that as it is written, that 1 milligram of calcium carbonate equivalent hardness in 1 liter. Okay, this is in 1 liter. So 1 milligram is one milligram of hardness in 1 liter in simple form. Okay, now when we elaborate it, that we know that what is the 1 liter. 1 liter is approximately equivalent to 1 kilogram, and your 1 kilogram is also equivalent to what? 10^6 milligram. Okay, 1 liter is equivalent to 1 kilogram, and 1 kilogram is equivalent to 10^6 milligram. So when we convert this value of liter by this, what we get? We get the value 1 milligram of calcium carbonate equivalent hardness in 10^6 milligrams. Okay, so this 1 milligram is now present in 10^6 milligram. In previously what we written, 1 milligram in 1 liter. And now if I simplify that again, there is 1 part of calcium carbonate equivalent hardness in 10^6 part. So what is the result? Result is that your value of ppm and your value of milligram per liter, which is milligram per liter, both are one and the same thing. It means you can write whether ppm or whether milligram per liter, and whatever it is written, both are the same thing. Means we can replace ppm by milligram per liter and milligram per liter by ppm. Okay, so first one is ppm, part per million. Second one is the milligram per liter. And now we will proceed our third unit, which is our degree of hardness. So third unit is degree clerks. So representation is in the form of degree, sign of degree, and then CL. So 1 degree clerk is 1 part of calcium carbonate equivalent hardness in 70,000 parts. Okay, so 1 part of calcium carbonate equivalent hardness in 70,000 parts. Now again, if we equal the ppm, because this is the basic value, ppm and then degree clerks, whatever there is, 1 part in 10^6 part in case of ppm, and here 1 part is in 70,000 part. Okay, like this. Now we equalize both values, then what we get, that we cancel out the value, then 10^2 is equals to 7. And at last what we get, that ppm is equivalent to 7, your ppm, and this is the degree clerks, then we have 7/100 or 0.07 degree clerks. So in simple form, what is the relation between ppm and degree clerks? Ppm is equals to 0.07 degree clerks. This is the relationship between ppm and between degree clerks. So your ppm is equivalent to this. So you can inter convert this value to ppm by multiplying this value, or you can converting this value by dividing this value. So this is the correlation between your ppm and your degree clerks. And we use this value in degree clerks just like that 1 grain in pounds. Means this is the 1 grain and this is the pound. this is not generally used in India, because in India we use only ppm, but in other outside our country we use different value. Okay,